Minas Iarokapis. How's that?
Great.
Minas is a computer scientist and a roboticist, and he's a founder of Open Bionics, which is a pretty cool organization that focuses on prosthetic limbs. Not just a prosthetic limb that doesn't do anything, but a prosthetic limb that has robotics inside of it. So please welcome Minas.
Okay, thank you guys for being here. I would like to thank also Hackaday organizers for inviting me. I will talk today about the Open Bionics, and this brought us the idea for Open Bionics. Not this, a bottle like that. I will talk about it. So Open Bionics focuses on robot and prosthetic hands. What's the problem? The problem nowadays is that amputees complain about the cost of buying and maintaining prosthesis. Prosthesis are expensive. And our goal is to provide a prosthesis that is affordable without compromising the functionality. So we want to keep the prosthesis lightweight, we want to be adaptive, we want to be as functional as possible, and even as functional as the commercially available prosthesis. Nowadays, the prosthetic market has solutions like the V-Bionic hand, the Michelangelo hand, and the iLimb Ultra Revolution, a modest name. And these guys gave us also an application for the iPhone because they have a prosthetic hand that has 5 motors, each one for the 5 fingers. So you use with the intact hand your iPhone in order to select the grasping posture. We'll talk about it later. And in the robotics literature, in the robotics research, we have the DLR-HIT2, the DLR hand arm system, the Sung hand and the Shadow hand. These hands are sophisticated with a lot of motors, a lot of sensors. They require complicated control laws, and they cost, again, up to $100,000. We bought this guy here, the DLR, and we had it in our lab, and it couldn't grasp this body, because it had a constrained aperture, a limited aperture. So we said, come on guys, we'll give you $60,000 for this thing or for this thing. Come on, something has to be changed in this market, and in this market also. A lot of groups nowadays focus on adaptive robot hands. This is another class of hands. We have the Yale Open Hand Initiative, we have the iHarvard Yale Hand, the KAUST, this is an initiative by Stanford, and of course we try also to develop some robot hands. And if you go to Open Robot Hardware, you will see a lot of people working on similar approaches. They use lightweight materials, they use compliance, they use under actuation, and they try to solve difficult problems with simple solutions. So, Open Bionics builds robot hands like this one, and it builds also prosthetic hands. This is the first version, and this is the second version. Here we use acrylic material. Here we have a 3D printed version, but we will talk about the details in the following slides. Initially, we said, okay, right now prostheses are of certain sizes. I mean, you go to the company and you say, I am a guy or I'm a girl and I need a prosthesis that looks like my hand. And they give you an approximate size. But you can find parametric models that if you compute the hand length and the hand breadth of the amputee, most of the amputees have one hand amputated, so they have an intact hand. So you use the intact hand to measure these parameters, and you have already all the phalanges lengths in order to create a personalized prosthetic hand. So we use these parametric models in order to develop personalized prostheses. Then we focused on simple materials because we wanted everyone to be able to replicate our design. So the first version used simple silicon sheets that you can buy in a hardware store. and it used not ABS filament, but for the second version, for the first version, we used simple plexiglass and a laser cutter. But of course, the design can be replicated with acrylic, ABS, wood, aluminum, whatever you want. It doesn't matter. Because the design essentially is 2D, so you can use 3D printing or laser cutters on, or even CNC. The first design had the silicon seats stitched onto the rigid phalanges. So we used simple needles. The second design, we used the hybrid deposition manufacturing technique, and we used the silicones and casting. And we used NFC tags as an example of sensors that can be embedded in the design. For example, here we touch the finger, and it opens our website. Why we did that? Because NFC sensors are something simple that anyone can use. The amputee, if he or she has a prosthetic hand, she cannot use as the smartphone, but she can touch with the prosthetic hand the smartphone, and the smartphone can, with the hand, she can have or he can have different shortcuts for the functionality of the smartphone. But inside this mold, you can put other sensors. You can put flex sensors or even force sensors, and you can augment the capabilities of prosthetic devices. The thumb has 9 different configurations. Why? Because human hand is considered as dexterous because we have the opposable thumb. The human thumb is that made us the beings that we are now. I mean, that created this brain, the functionality and the dexterity of the human hand. And here you can see 2 different configurations of the robot thumb. Here you can see also another idea, a selectively lockable differential mechanism that is used in order to minimize not only the weight, but also the number of the motors. So what we did is that we used 3 different bars. These bars are constrained with fingers, and you use only one motor to replicate, to have 144 different grasping gestures. So what we did is that we took the idea of iLimb to use the iPhone, and we said, okay, instead of iPhone, we will use these buttons, and we will have different grasping postures and gestures with $200. You can see here the differential mechanism with the palm open. Here you can see the different grasping postures and gestures that can be replicated, and some examples of the robot hand grasping and interacting with the environment. And this is the new version. And here we can see that this new hand can grasp a big bottle of water that weighs 1.5 kilos. So, in our websites, you can find the guides in order to replicate not only the robot hands, but also the prosthetic hands. Future plans. We need to do clinical trials. We need feedback from amputees. We need to ameliorate our designs. We are not ready yet. Open Bionics just started. We want to focus eventually not only on new designs, but also on human augmentation devices. And we want to collaborate with people. And regarding the title of this presentation, can we revolutionize prosthetics? A lot of companies use phrases like, we will revolutionize prosthetics or robotics, and we will change the world. We feel that only a community can revolutionize prosthetics or any field, not initiatives or companies. We cannot do it alone. We need help. And if you search out there, you will see that not only the hacker spaces and the maker space around the world, but there are also very nice projects. The Enabling the Future initiative, the X prosthetic hand, the BioHand, that was also a Hackaday project, I think semi-finalist. I mean, if we collaborate, we can do great stuff. This is the team. Agesilaos Simatos was also in SatNox last year. He was a finalist. It's the second year that he is a finalist, and it's a great honor for him to be a finalist again. Christoforos Mavrogiannis, George Kotoudis, and our advisor during my PhD studies, Kostas Kyriakopoulos, that provides consulting for different stuff that has to do with research. Acknowledgements. I would like to thank the Hackaday community for all the feedback. I had great comments from a lot of guys. Athens Hackerspace for providing equipment in order that we used in order to build our PCBs and all that stuff. Control Systems Lab, the Yale Open Hand Project, we took a lot of ideas from them. RoboDallin, we won an innovation award 2 months ago, and they want to help us in order to develop open source solutions. And they don't care that we are for non-profit, that we may create an NPO, for example. And Open Robot Hardware that hosts the different open projects. Thank you very much for your time.
That's great. Thanks for your talk. Yeah, go that way to the Q&A area. So we're going to take another short break for about 5 minutes. No, we're not. One more? Okay. Sorry about that. Snap. We'll do coffee afterwards.